All right, we good. I was expounding on, I think, before the camera cut, that battery died. Like I said, if you're part of that great number, the 144,000, you won't judge angels, man. Matter of fact, I'm going to read the scripture. This is what we got for to look forward to. Don't worry about these demons. Don't worry about the trials and tribulations. Brothers, hold on, man. Fight the good fight of faith, man. Because you're not doing this in vain. Alright? You're not doing this in vain, man. Anyway, let me read 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 1. It says, so like I said before, you got these demons and scoffers and age of provocateurs. You know what I'm saying? That guy, come on. He can't see past you, man. The superior's told him to come out here and start madness. And the scriptures cut it, man. And where is he at now? He fled. The wicked fleeth, but no man pursueth, man. Right? Don't think, even for you other brothers out there, you got spies amongst you as well. You gotta be mindful of that. Not every brother's a brother. Don't think these devils don't got their eye on you, man. They got their eye on me right now. Got agents coming up to the camp. Record what you're saying. They send females up here. You know what I'm saying? Act like they're on the phone. That's these devils, man. So I'm saying, when the hour and you guys that fell out, you're a bunch of fools, man, because you won't be defended. And I'm going to get that scripture too. 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 1. No, I'm going to jump to the point, verse 2. Do we not know that the saints shall judge the world? And the world shall be judged by you, who are the saints. Saints is the Latin word sanctus, which means holy, the Israelites. But it's mainly talking about the first fruits, the 144,000, and then the one-third. It says, do we not know that the saints shall judge the world? So we're going to judge these other nations. Who are we going to judge? Other nations, man. So there is no equality. There never was. That's foolishness. Okay? The white man talked that nonsense about all men are equal, but when he wrote the Constitution, Negroes were enslaved, man. So get out of here with that. Do we not know that the saints shall judge the world? And if the world shall be judged by you, are ye unworthy to judge the smallest matters? Know we not that we shall judge angels? How much more things that pertain to this life? So Paul was saying, listen, you guys are old enough and mature enough spiritually to judge matters amongst yourselves. Okay? Because we gonna judge the world to come and we gonna judge angels. We gonna tell angels what to do, man. That's how much power the Lord has promised you. Power, man, beyond your wildest imagination. More than that you can ever get in this kingdom. See, a lot of dudes, they worry about their image. You know, you gotta look like a fool for the Lord's sake, man. Because like I told you before, there will be a reward. I'm gonna read this precept. Isaiah. Devils don't get put to death. It says, says, Isaiah chapter 60, verse 10. It's the kingdom of heaven right here. Just, you gotta look forward to it. And the sons of strangers shall build up thy walls. Ooh, these other nations, man. We're not gonna be doing a damn thing in the world to come. Why? Because we built up America for it. And it reaped none of the benefits. None. Still the last one high, the first one high. High incarceration rates, ghettos, reservations, guns, drugs, abortion clinics, every fucking way you go, man. Bad food, bad water, being targeted by the medical industry. You're the experiment. So-called Negroes, Hispanics, and Native Indians. Look at the Tuskegee experiment, man. Okay? What the white man did to the Native Indians with that smallpox, man. And other things that you don't know about. Alright? Because he's the devil, man. He's the wicked one. Alright? It says verse 10. But this is what we got forward to look forward to. Okay? If you have that faith, it takes a man of faith to believe in what the Bible is saying. If you don't have faith, then remain in a Christian church. Remain in a Christian church and sing songs all day, man, like a bunch of fools, man. How could you sing when we're not even in our land yet, when we're not even saved yet, man? Like King David said, how can I sing a song in a strange land, which is Babylon? He was prophesying in the spirit. Okay? And he said, what? That take thy little ones, Esau, Edom, be white, dashing against the stone, man. That's what we can sing. Right now, we got nothing to sing about. Not right now. We at the time of warfare, man. Spiritually. And the Most High gonna raise us up physically. And that's when everybody's gonna want to get right. But verse 10. And the sons of strangers shall build up thy walls, and their kings shall minister unto thee. These rulers, the Rothschilds, the DuPonts, the Gettys, these prime ministers, these elite bankers and investors, okay, Obama as too, they gonna what? Build up the walls in the world to come. Servitude. Okay, the Most High deals with that because his people have to serve. And the scripture says it wasn't meant for us to drink that cup, but we drunk it. Alright? Verse 10. And the sons of strangers. What? Alright, have a good day, bro. Have a good day. And the sons of strangers shall build up thy walls, and their kings shall minister unto thee. For in my wrath I smote thee, but in my favor have I had mercy on thee with the elect. So the Most High said in his wrath, he gave us over to these other nations. Okay? Verse 11. Therefore thy gates shall be open continually. There shall not be shut day nor night, that men may bring unto thee the forces of the Gentiles, and their kings may be brought. So what? In the kingdom of heaven, the scripture says that what? The gates gonna be open continually. It's constantly bringing riches upon riches upon riches upon riches upon riches. The first 1,000 years is gonna be very, very, very bitter. Because it's gonna be hardcore slavery. After the 1,000 years, then these other nations gonna get their lands back. But Esau, Edom is the only nation that's gonna be done away with forever and ever and ever. Amen. Period. But the scripture says if the gates gonna be open continually, man. And that's a very long time.
Yeah. All right? Now just give me tell
verse 12. Now this is the Most High speaking. This is Yahweh speaking. Okay? For the nation and kingdom that will not serve thee shall perish. So the Most High said, you don't serve his people in the world to come, you're going to perish, man. You're going to get put to death. Which death is going to happen anyway. Yeah, these nations shall be utterly wasted. the glory of Lebanon, which are the Arab nation, Ishmael, shall come unto thee, the fir tree, the pine tree, and the box together, to beautify the place of my sanctuary, the temple. So they're going to have to build up the temple, man. They're going to have to build up Jerusalem first. And then you're going to build up these other planets. That's another thing you got to look forward to in the kingdom of the Most High, man. Going to other worlds and other galaxies, man. And the elect is going to inherit all things through Yahweh. All right? The glory of Lebanon shall come unto the fir tree, the pine tree, and the box together to beautify the place of my sanctuary. And I will make the place of my feet glorious. Better than Solomon's King. The sons also of them that afflicted thee to all nations shall abandon us, and all they that despise thee shall bow down themselves. I'm going to read that again. Salakia. Verse 14. The sons also of them that afflicted thee shall abandon unto thee. Shall bow themselves down at the soles of thy feet, and they shall call thee the city of the Lord, the city of Yahweh, Yahweh Shai, the Zion, the Holy One of Israel. So they gonna come bending unto whom? The prophets of the Most High Son, and the rest of all Israel. Okay, so it's good. Second Ezra chapter that perish in this life. I'm gonna pan the camera.
2/3, these other nations.
So I'm gonna read on. 2 Ezra chapter 7, verse 20. For there be many that perish in this life, because they despise the law of the Most High that is set before them. And these people, they despise righteousness, man. Alright? They despise righteousness, man. That's why they do the things that they do. Homosexuality, adultery, transgender, gender bending, all that wicked shit, man. Because they despise the laws of Yahweh, why Yahweh Shai, man. For the Most High have given straight commandments to such as Cain, what they should do to live, even as they, Cain, and what they should observe to avoid punishment. But you know what? They not. So I'm going to keep going. Nevertheless, they were not obedient unto him, but spake against him, and imagined vain things. That's two-thirds. That's two-thirds of our people, man. Alright? They imagine a vain thing. Oh, I'm going to get my doctorate or master's. I'm going to try to build me this house. Well, who are you voting for? Who are you voting for? You're imagining a vain thing. Because this society is going down. You're trying to hold on to something that's falling. The scripture said, remember Lot's wife. Remember Lot's wife. Here this destruction happens. The Most High gave a straight commandment to the angels. Do not look back. She looked back because she had great possession. That's imagining the main thing. So we spiritually not supposed to look back. And deceive themselves by their wicked deeds instead of the Most High that he is not and do not his ways. I'm going to jump to the point, verse 26. Verse 25. And therefore, Ezra, for the empty are empty days, and for the full are the full days. Behold, the time shall come that these wicked, which I told thee, shall come to pass, and the bride shall appear, as she cometh forth shall be seen, that now is withdrawn from the earth. And whosoever is delivered from the foresaid evils shall see my wonders, which is the kingdom. What are the foresaid evils that the Bible's talking about? The Most High visiting this planet earth by terror. The economy collapsing. Famine, martial law, the chin, race riots, World War III, disease warfare. They tried Ebola, swine flu, now they coming with the Zika virus. You see what I'm saying? That's the devil coming down with great wrath because he knows he has but a short time. And above all, the new world order. That's the foresaid evils where Esau wants to depopulate the world down to 500 million and set up his kingdom. Okay, and the foundation of it is the microchip. That's why they're going to destroy this currency and bring forth a cashless society. And when that comes forth, that is it. We are at the end. But those are the foresaid evils that the scriptures are talking about. For my son Jesus, or Yahweh Shai, shall be revealed with those that be with him. And they that remain shall rejoice within 400 years. After these years shall my son Christ die, that all men may have life. And he already did that. So that part is already fulfilled. What's out here, man? Shit. It says, verse 41. This is Ezra. Even so now, seeing corruption is grown up and wickedness increase. That's what I said before. That's when you got an influx of homosexuality, man. And it's all gender bending, the transgender movement. Okay, that's wickedness increasing. You see what I'm saying? Everything that was abnormal or perverse once upon a time has now become the norm, like this. See? That's an example of what I was talking about, man. And all that's going to perish. Even so, seeing corruption is grown up and wickedness increase. And the righteous pray for the ungodly, wherefore shall it not be so now also? He answered me and said, this present life is not the end, where much glory doeth abide. Therefore have they prayed for the weak, but the day of doom, which is what? The day of Yahweh Shai, man. The second coming. He's going to judge this planet Earth. That's the thing we've been waiting for, man. The day of the Lord. And Lord willing, we be a part of the elect. Because if you're not of the elect, oh boy. No one can help you in that time. No one. Alright? Verse. The day of doom shall be the end of this time and the beginning of immortality. Paul said, who shall deliver me from the body of this death? Alright? Wherefore, intemperance is at its end, infidelity is cut off, righteousness is grown, and the truth is sprung up. Then shall no man be able to save him that is destroyed. So two-thirds, there's no hope. And two-thirds of you Negro Hispanics and you Native Indians that refuse to get right, that would remain gang-banging, drug-dealing, being promiscuous, adultery, and sexuality. Y'all gonna be destroyed, man, and ain't no one to save you, man. Alright? Because you had ample time to get your act together. And the signs are showing. Alright? Every week is bombings, explosions, signs in the sun, signs in the moon. Alright? You had four blood moons. That's the draw of the second chapter, man. All these celebrities dropping dead, when exited from the EU. Okay? That's the signs of the times. Disease warfare, now you got the so-called Zika virus down in Miami, which is as well as the cracking devices of the devil, man. The further vaccinate you and depopulate you. Because this gender is what? Eugenics. Now, let me read on. It says, there shall no man be able to save him that is destroyed, but to crush him that has gotten the victory, man. That's what people get the victory. That's what the angel said. And we'll read on. Then he answered me and said, this is the condition of the battle, which a man that is born upon the earth shall fight. And if he overcome, he shall suffer as thou hast said. But if he get the victory, he shall receive the thing that I say, man. No matter what, that he corrupts the power. So what you gotta understand is that every Israel is right with the Israelites. We'll be right back. verse 4. So the Bible says, whatsoever is brought upon thee, take cheerfully, and be patient when thou art changed to a lower state. So whatever the Most High put upon you, man, the scripture says, take it with patience, man. Or more, you gotta stand on your faith. We all be trying. I keep saying that every week. Confounding. but any abide in his fear, was forsaken. For whom did he ever despise that called upon him? For the Lord is full of compassion and mercy, long-suffering and very pitiful, and forgiveth sins and saveth in time of affliction. Now we don't want that mercy. Okay? Because to go out by the way of famine is a nasty way to go out. And a lot of our people, they don't see that. They can't eat when they're in a concentration camp. I answered and spake unto them again of parables and said, the kingdom of heaven is like unto a certain king which made marriage for his son. The king is Yahweh and the son is Yahweh Shai. Okay, the marriage is what? Joining the 12 tribes back to the Father, man, and receiving power and rulership. And sent forth his servants to call them that were bidden to the wedding, and they would not come. Again he sent forth servants, saying, tell them which are bidden, behold, I prepared my dinner, which is the kingdom. My oxen, my fatlings are killed, and all things are ready. Come unto the marriage, man. And that's what we preaching right now, the marriage. Joining together with Yahweh Shai. Okay? But they made light of it, and went their ways, one to his farm, another to his merchandise. So that's what, brothers, that's preoccupied, man. Making a million one excuses not to do this work, man. You other brothers out there that got the talent, pray, man, and the Most High will give you the strength to do what you got to do. Alright, you're supposed to know your gift and your talent, man. Whether it's prophesying, whether it's teaching, whether it's being a help, whether it's making the garments, whether it's making the signs, doing the artwork, okay? Every brother's not going to be on the same level. The body got different functions and different organs, so you have to find out where you fit in, okay? Anyway, it says, let me keep going on. It says, and the remnant took his servants Verse 5. But they made light of it and went their ways, one to his farm, another to his merchandise. And the remnant took his servants and entreated them spitefully and slew them. And when the king heard thereof, he was wroth, and he sent forth his armies and destroyed those murderers and burned up their city. Which is who? Two-thirds of our people, man, that killed the prophets, man. Scripture says, Jerusalem, Jerusalem, thou that killest the prophets, man. Okay, we see these, them same demons are back on the planet Earth, and it's wrong. A lot of them are on the common board, a lot of them walk past the camp. Okay, a lot of them see the videos online and just talk their madness, man. Okay? Then said to his servants, the wedding is ready. That's what we teach in the kingdom is at hand. Okay? They which were bidden were not worthy. And this is what the Lord said. Go we therefore into the highways, and as many as you shall find, bid to the marriage. So you have to go out to the highways and entrance.
The chief place of concourse. Okay? This is where you gotta come out to, man.
Lord's house might be filled. The house of faith. You gotta be seen, man. You can't be behind people, you know, going to some damn church building. That's too easy. You gotta deal with the elements. I just seen early, you gotta deal with people. Oh, you gotta do it a lot of times. People not even listening to you. You're looking like a madman, speaking to the air. That's all part of the ministry, and that's the way the Most High set it up. Okay? Just gotta deal with it, man. It says, so those servants went into the highways and gathered together all as many as they found, both bad and good. So you guys that fell out, you were part of the bad. You were made an example of what not to do. And we all got to pray that we're not a part of that lot. The way you remain that you're not a part of that lot, you got to remain humble. And you got to remain prolific. You gotta keep doing this work. You can't be idle. Because none of us got a ticket for the chariots yet. None. None of us, man. We all gotta work. Why do you think the elders keep working? Even though they put in so many years, they have to keep working. You can't take breaks, man. You can't take a hiatus. The Most High don't play them type of games. Satan don't take breaks. Okay, neither do the Most High. Alright? It says, both bad and good, and the wedding was furnished with guests. And when the king came in to see the guests, he saw there was a man that had not on his wedding garment. Which ain't talking about the physical garments, it's talking about the truth. Alright? And he said unto him, friend, how camest thou hither not having a wedding garment? And he was speechless. And that's what happened to all you guys, man, that fell out. Okay, you're not going to have nothing to say when you see these things happen. Okay, you're going to be convicted in your conscience. You're going to know that you messed up. Alright? Then he said to the king, to the servants, bind him hand and foot, and take him away, and cast him into utter darkness. It shall be weeping and gnashing of the teeth. And this is the point. For many are called, but few are chosen, and the few is the elect. Starting with 144,000, man. So that's what the Lord said this. Revelation chapter 3, verse 20. Revelation chapter 3. Revelation chapter 3. Well, it's good too about the lukewarm, but I want to get something else. Yeah, I was right. Revelation 3. So I'm going to move on to the next segment after this. Revelation chapter 3. Verse 15. I'm going to read down to 18. I know thy works, that thou neither cold nor hot. I would thou wert cold or hot. So then, because thou art lukewarm and neither cold nor hot, I will spew thee out of my mouth. So the Lord is only dealing with people that's on fire. You kind of in it, come out this week, don't come out for the next 3 weeks. You come out now and you took breaks, hiatuses, he's not dealing with you. The Most High don't deal with men like that. Okay? Because the truth won't be able to go forth. Imagine the elders kept taking breaks. Then brothers won't wake up. Okay? We keep coming out here amongst these people, condemn them, edify. We have to edify. We put it online, the World Wide Web. And it travels, man. And whoever has to edify, it edifies. The Lord wakes up when he wants to wake up, man. We're just mouthpiece. Okay? He has to unseal your mind, your plan, for you to get it. Okay? But you have to keep going until the latter end, man. Okay, I mean, there will come a time when we have to stop preaching out here. That's the hour of temptation, when all hell start breaking loose. We're not going to be out here no more, man. Our days of prophesying going to be done. That's when we're finished. But right now, we've got to keep going until it happens. So it says that even when it happens, we have to endure. All right? Remain our integrity to the end. But because thou sayest, I am rich, increased with goods, and have need of nothing, and knowest not thou art wretched, miserable, and poor, and blind, and naked, which are committing sin. Which means what? You're of the world. Verse 18 is the point. Of salvation. And that's the garments you gotta clothe yourself with, man. We're not talking about the physical garments with the fringes, even though we have that on. But the main garments is the garments of salvation. And part of the salvation is having the name. He hath covered me with the robe of righteousness, as a bridegroom decked himself with ornaments, and a bride adorned herself with her jewels. So the truth, you have to clothe yourself with the entire book. Okay, that's how you're going to be saved or delivered, man. Okay, that's the garments of salvation. And if you don't have that garment, you fall out, your shame is going to be seen. Number one, you put yourself to open shame, and you put the Lord to an open shame, man. You to come out here and rebuke people and go back into the world, like the scripture says, like a dog returning to his vomit. Right?